I know that home is beautiful. I know you're driving around, you looked at the front yard, you looked at the home, the size, you looked at the basketball hoop that would go right in the driveway, three-car garage, whatever it is, all the features you're dreaming of. That sign's in the front yard, you want to call it so bad, and you want to say, let's put the offer in, it's great. That agent is thinking, I'm going to make double the money. Heck yes, put the offer in, let's go. Now we hit a wall. Can I afford it? Like going to a restaurant, really nice restaurant, steakhouse, seafood, whatever you want to do. But you go and you have no idea what the prices are, and the check comes and you look and you don't have your wallet. That would be backwards, right? We wouldn't go in there and say, I don't have my wallet, let's just go eat. Let's go to the most expensive place. This would be great because it doesn't matter about the bill. But on our biggest investment of our life, and a lot of clients don't know this, right? Biggest investment of life, we go in with no wallet, no idea if we can buy it at all. It's just go. Well, what's the monthly payment? How much money down is it going to be for a down payment? What are the closing costs? Do you have any idea what, how any of this stuff works? This is what a true mortgage professional or real estate agent has to tell you. I see things all over the mix. I'll see clients just drive by the place and go, we'll get it. They'll even sign an actual contract and we'll get it and say, well, you don't even, you came to me after the fact. Like, I can't help you now. Now we're trying to find co-signers. We're trying to get out of it and find a way. The best clients will come in and they'll actually say, let me fill out my information. Can you tell me this is a yes or no? I don't want to get my hopes up. And that's hard because you look at these beautiful places and it's just, it's go time. There's nothing fun or cool about talking to a mortgage professional about your tax returns. It's horrible having to deal with that and dig up things from maybe it was a divorce in the past and asked for a divorce decree and all these different things. There's nothing great about that. But have that conversation up front. Please, please, please have it. It will save you so much time and energy later on, and you'll make the best decision. Don't just send in an online app. If you were to make, just say you've made $180,000 a year, really, you made about $18,000. And you go and get the pre-approval, because they're just going off what you're saying, and they're going off credit, right? There's a couple factors that a lender was going off of. They may send a pre-qual letter and say, you're good to go. And you put the offer in, now you have a home inspection, now you have an appraisal. And now you have escrow deposit you have to put in. You could be out of pocket a lot of money. What you want to do is, yes, you want to go for the pre-qual. That's great. So you did step one. Step two is submit your documentation. You don't have to pay anything. You have no money out of pocket to actually submit that. It's free homework. Let the lender do their homework up front. It doesn't cost you anything. And if they're saying it's going to cost you something, bail, run. It doesn't. So do the homework up front. Does that $180,000, is it $180,000 a year that you make? Or was it $18,000 and you forgot a zero? One of these things have happened. Did you just go self-employed? Because although you make a ton of money, I can't use it at all. Did you go from base and then you went to straight commission? I can't use the income at all. Did you just started a part-time business that you were banking on that income? Can't use that either. Was the money, did you just take out a big personal loan for your down payment? All these things are issues that we see after the fact. So let us look at that stuff up front. And when you were just about to go buy this brand new car and then buy the house, we would tell you, hold on a second, no major purchases. So get the advice up front. Again, look for a five-star professional. Don't just go because you saw a commercial and you're gonna go with this outfit because you see the commercials all the time. It's all about who you deal with. Whoever you talk to, look that person up. They have an NMLS number. You can look them up if they're an agent. You can look them up. They should have social profiles. They should have reviews, a lot of them online. And if they do have a lot of the reviews and they answer fast, and if they tell you they call you at 10, they call you at 10. But if they're on their game, that's good. That's true five-star service. So going in, pre-qual, send documents. You can actually upload them to secure portals. Send the documents in, let the lender scrub it, let the realtor and lender work together so they know, hey, I'm going to put the offer at $700,000. The lender would say, well, you can, but I have them approved at $500,000. So where are we going to get this $200,000? Is the seller going to give them $200,000? Are you going to give them $200,000? Because I don't have a loan for that. So be careful. A lot of times, some agents, some lenders, you got to figure, if they're only doing one deal a month, the average agent does 8 to 12 deals a year. A full-time agent does 8 to 12 deals a year. lenders aren't far better. That one deal is going to either help them stay in the business and pay their mortgage, their rent, their car, their student loans. And if they don't close that deal, they can't pay their bills. So do you think they're trying to close this deal? I'm not saying that's all lenders whatsoever, but I have seen it over the years where they're pressing like crazy to close this one deal because if they don't, they can't make ends meet. You want to go to a five-star professional so they can give you very good advice. And that one deal will not make or break them. Their ultimate goal is to put you into the home and do repeat business, but just make you happy. It's just being ethical. Do the right thing. Prequal, upload your documents, get a format. You want to know what the payment is so you don't have sticker shock later on after you're under contract saying that payment's way too high. Know what you're going to be out of pocket. And it's a beautiful conversation because after that, you're very secure in making that decision and you don't have sleepless nights, especially a week away from closing. Or if you wanted to back out a week or a day before closing, you really can't. It's hard and you'll lose a lot of money if you do. Upfront is where the homework is done. It doesn't cost you anything. Just do it. And then the decision after the fact is so much more rewarding. You can concentrate on what type of drapes you want. If you want to remodel the kitchen, the backyard, I want a grotto in the backyard. Do I want to redo the driveway and put another basketball hoop in? What do you want to do in the place? But you can think about furniture and all these fun things, how you want to style the place, as opposed to, I think I made a bad decision and my wife and I are at each other's throats and we don't know if we should move from North Carolina to Miami because I don't know what's going on. Did I take the job offer? Should I not take the job offer? So a lot of these things come in when it's done incorrect. I hope this helps. Thanks.